In this video, you will discover how to plan an indoor stockpile inspection and volumetric calculation. There are two objectives when flying in an indoor stockpile: inspecting the structure of the warehouse and conveyor belt, and performing volumetric calculations of the stockpile. In both cases, the preparation of the asset and most of the risks will be the same. Only the flight plan will differ slightly. As always, the first safety consideration is for the pilot and co-pilot. Both should be in a safe area, out of the way of vehicles, and if possible, in an area that won't become too dusty for their comfort. Ideally, the pilot should not face a headwind, as airborne particles lifted by the drone during the inspection would fly straight towards them. As always, the right PPE should be worn by the pilot and co-pilot. This should include safety goggles and a dust mask. Regarding drone safety, a few risks need to be considered. In indoor stockpiles, there can be strong airflow. When possible, try to limit the openings in the warehouse to reduce wind drafts. This to have a more stable flight in the asset, and also to limit the risk of having the drone pushed out of the warehouse. Hanging objects and cables can also pose risks, so always direct your camera in the direction of your flight. Conveyor belts over the stockpile are another risk, as there is always the potential for loose material to fall, even when they are empty. Losing visibility due to high dust concentration is another concern. In stockpiles of fine material, it is necessary to pause the conveyor belt a few hours before the inspection to allow the fine particles to settle. Without this, it might be impossible to navigate and collect quality data. If possible, also plan to fly a few meters above the stockpile to avoid lifting unnecessary dust. The dome in which we will be flying is 45 meters in diameter and 25 meters high. Our objective is to perform a volumetric calculation of this stockpile. For this, we need a good point cloud of the entire stockpile and must identify what is considered the floor of the stockpile. Often, the floor is covered with stock material that must be included in our volume calculation. If there is a concrete floor beneath the stockpile, remove some of the stock material to expose a small portion of the actual floor, allowing Elios to scan it. Another option is to use the bottom part of the outdoor doors as the reference floor. We plan to fly all around the stockpile to get good coverage of the bottom part and the connection between the floor and the beginning of the dome. Then, we will circle again around the stockpile, almost over the top. We will make 4 to 8 360-degree turns around the stockpile to avoid any holes in our model. With the point cloud on the tablet, we can check for any holes in the model during the flight. As there can be hanging objects or cables holding the conveyor belt, we are particularly careful when flying close to the ceiling. We always fly forward to be able to see these risks and avoid them if necessary. Depending on the material in your stockpile and how volatile it is, you might have to fly up to 8 meters over the material to avoid lifting too much fine dust, which would reduce visibility and create a lot of noise in the point cloud. You might also need to let the material settle down between flights for 5 to 20 minutes, depending on the material and airflow in the warehouse. Once back at the office, we will use the live map point cloud and the software cloud compare to start the volumetric calculation. The first step is to import the point cloud into cloud compare. Then, we select the point cloud and apply the iDome lighting. We use the cross-section tool to remove part of the ceiling and the points far from the dome. Using the clipping tool, we remove the roof structure of the dome. It's important to identify what is considered the floor level, as this will be necessary to define the floor of the stockpile and from where the volume calculation should start. After clipping the dome structure, apply a statistical outlier removal filter to remove some dust effects over and under the top of the stockpile. Then you should create a planar floor. By doing this, you make sure you control the height of the stockpile. To do so, select the Edit and Planar Floor, select Create. You need to select the width and height of the planar fit and select OK. Then, select the plan you just created and, using the Translate tool, place it under the stockpile at the real floor level you scanned previously. To keep the floor plan intact, it is recommended to deselect the rotation option. When you are satisfied, click the green logo. The next step is to convert the plan you created into a point cloud. Simply click on point sampling on the mesh. No need to change the number of point there, simply click on OK. You can rename the new plan to make sure you are selecting the right one in the next step. Select the floor and the point cloud, then open the 2.5 volume calculation tool. For the ground, select the floor and choose the interpolate option for the empty cells. For the ceiling source, select the stockpile and also choose the interpolate option for the empty cells. Leave the grid step at 0.2, set the projection direction to Z, and select average height. Then, click on update. After a short processing time, you will see the added volume displayed in cubic meters. The illustration on the right shows what was considered in the calculation. If needed, you can export the grid as a cloud and display it over, or instead of your stockpile point cloud, to see what went into your volumetric calculation. There are, of course, other software programs available for volumetric calculations, but this one has the advantage of being free. While we do not offer support for this software, we do provide guidance on how to use it with our data.